everyone, how are you all? Hope you are doing great at home. Today we are going to take the third topic, or you can say third part of the topic, how federalism is practiced in India, or if we call in the form of question, that what is the reason behind the success of federalism in India. Okay, we have seen 2 points previously, language policy of India and linguistic states. We have seen that how liberal India is towards its languages spoken in India, right? And as language is very sensitive issue, if we don't adopt a liberal point of view or liberal policy, then it may lead to conflicts in the society, then conflicts may get the form of violence, then war, etc. But India has passed that test with good marks, as we said before, right? So now we will see another test of Indian federalism, which is on the basis of center-state relations. Okay, this you will be able to connect more with the concept federalism, because as the meaning of the federalism is the sharing of power between the central and state level, means levels of the government. Okay, so here we will see that sharing or the relations of center and state. Okay, now before we get started with these points, okay, which are, you know, given in your book, which you're supposed to write in your book, let us just first understand the history, okay, a bit. Now you all know, for the purpose of elections, country is divided into 543 constituencies, right? You can see here, but few are in color, like the 423 are for general. This purplish color, it is for SC, 79 seats are reserved for SC, and ST, 41 seats, okay? So now, let us come to the main point. We have seen, till 1980s, government was always formed by INC or Indian National Congress, okay? Government, when we say government was formed by Indian National Congress, it means government was formed on the basis of majority, means it had absolute majority. Now, what do we mean by absolute majority? As 543 seats are there, okay, so it means at 543 places elections are conducted, okay, and in all these, as you can see these divisions here, at all these 543 places, different parties, they have their candidates contesting elections, okay. For example, BJP's candidates will be there in all 543 constituencies. Then Congress candidates will be there in all 543 constituencies. So in this way, other parties, okay? So whichever party will get majority of the votes in one particular constituency, that party will win elections in that constituency particularly, okay? So now in this way, the party which gets more than half of the seats, means more than half of the 543 plus 1. So we say the number 273, okay? So the party which gets 273 seats, it means party which wins elections in 273 constituencies, that party we say as this party has won the elections, or this party will form government with absolute majority, okay? So now till 1980s, Congress was getting absolute majority. It was particularly till 1989. But then after that, what happened, and in different constituencies or in different states, regional parties, they started coming into power, they started winning elections. As Congress was national level party, okay, you may it might have happened, you know, it did not know the people of different regions very, you know, from that those details, etc., which regional parties might have known, right? So regional parties started winning elections. Now Congress was no more able to form government with majority, okay? Because to form government, it needed 273 seats, which it did not get. Let us say it got 200 seats, okay? Now with 200 seats, we cannot say Congress has won the elections. It might have got majority of the you can say seats, okay, but this number will not allow Congress to form the government. So now what will happen, it will want other parties to come and join with Congress or make alliance with Congress and give their seats to them, okay? in this way, what will happen? It will also have to share its power with them. Now let us take example of AIDMK in Tamil Nadu. Okay, so now when this system of coalition government started, now I hope you all are knowing coalition government, when no party gets majority, okay, no single party gets majority, means no single party, if we are talking about India, no single party gets 273 seats, then what happens? Other parties, means with whatever parties it has good relations, okay, they will come together to form majority, you know, to make this number 273 or more than that, okay. So this we call as coalition government, or in Hindi, which is, you know, in news channels you might have heard many a time, Gathbandhan ki sarkar. When different parties together they form the government, okay, because one single party was not able to get those 273 seats. Okay, so now what happened, you know, gradually what started happening, initially only Congress was ruling, but now it had also to share its power with other regional parties. Okay, let us say AIDMK in Tamil Nadu, it has formed alliance with the Congress, okay, to make Congress form government at the center, because Congress lacked seats. Now if their Congress is about to take any decision for the country, then AIDMK also knows that it has its share in the seats, right? So it may say that, you know, they don't want that decision to be taken. At this time Congress cannot take any decision unilaterally, because it knows if it will not listen or recognize the views of AIDMK, then AIDMK may take back its seat, or you can say it may break that alliance with Congress, then again the government will fall down. Government toot jayegi, gir jayegi, isko hum bolte, then again there will be elections, right? So to avoid that, Congress will also have to listen to AIDMK. Now this is just an example, because the government, the alliance can be with different parties or number of parties. Okay, so in this way what started happening actually, now Congress had to share power with other governments also, other political parties also. Now this was actually when federalism started getting practiced in India. Okay, so Congress era came to an end, coalition era now started. Okay, so now no single party was able to get majority. So now coalition government came into existence. Then if we see elections of 2014, then Congress performed really very poor and it got only 44 seats. At present, if we see, it won, in Lok Sabha, it has only 52 seats out of 443, and in Rajya Sabha, out of 245, it has only 42 seats. And if we see in how many states Congress has its government, it is only 6 states. Okay, so gradually this that was, you know, one party ruling the country, this concept came to an end. Now coalition government came into existence. Now we will get back to our topic. This was very necessary to understand this topic. Now restructuring the center-state relations is the one way in which federalism has been strengthened its practice. It was another way, right? Through which we have strengthened our federalism, okay? Changing the relations of center-state or restructuring center or state government relationship. Now, if no single party gets the majority in the Lok Sabha, the major national parties can alliance with many parties, including several regional parties, to form a government at center. So, this we have already seen. This led to now a new culture of power sharing and respect to the autonomy of state governments. Now, this was a new culture of sharing power with state governments. Here, we will see. Now, situation during Congress monopoly. Now you will understand, because we have already discussed it. For major part of the country, same party was in power in both center and state. In the state governments also, there was a government of Congress only. At the center also, there was government of Congress party only. So as a result, state governments were not in a position to enjoy their rights. State governments, as right now, state governments have whatever, you know, enormous rights. That time they did not have. Okay, because whenever there was a different party in power in particular state, let us say now, you know, when we said that different regional parties started winning elections, if you say in Tamil Nadu, AIDMK won elections instead of Congress, then now what happened? as Congress government knew that at center it has a center government is formed by Indian National Congress, right? So it was very proud, or you can say it was used to look low, or you can say undermine the powers or the dignity or the respect of the regional parties or the state governments. Okay, state governments were not given powers by the center. So constitution was usually misused to topple unfriendly government in those states. Now constitution to have made the arrangement of power sharing between center and state, but how it was practiced that time the government, that party, whatever party formed government, they did not practice it properly. Okay, so that time India was not a successful federal country, but it was gradually when Congress era or Congress monopoly came to an end, that time we say that India started becoming more and more federal. Okay, so situation in the era of coalition government, now we are comparing situation in the during Congress monopoly, where state governments, they were not having proper rights, okay, and they were undermined by the central government. But now in the coalition government after 1989 especially, pattern had shifted to multi-party coalition government at center. As a result, a new culture of power sharing and respect for the autonomy of state government has also developed. It can be said that now the federalism is more developed in India. Okay, so as we right now also know, at center, Congress government is formed by BJP. BJP won with absolute majority. But at the same time, it is not so that in all the states there is government of BJP. In different states, there are governments formed by different other parties, right? As we say that in Maharashtra, there is coalition government, right? Then such in this as in Punjab, there is Congress government and all. So in this way, what has happened, the structure, federal structure of a country or the government has developed in, you can say, more deeper way, more elaborated way. Okay, so now not only one party, but more different parties, they have their own power. Means power is not only with the hands of one party, but it is shared with other parties also. At the same time, state governments are also having their monopoly, or you can say autonomy, or they also have their powers. Okay, means now the government, it depends on the government at the center, right? Constitution has just led the we can say foundation guidelines that how it should be practiced. It then depends on the people, those who are in power, that how do they practice. Okay, so now we see that India has become more federal because now power is shared between center and state. We see how it is shared, right? You must listen to the news, at least 10 minutes a day. You will get to know that what happens in the country, what is going on in the center and different state governments, how they take decisions very independently. So now we see India has become, in two terms, it has become a federal country. So this is these three are the major reasons for making India a successful federal country. One, we have seen linguistic state, then we have seen language policy, and now we have seen center-state relations, okay? If you have any queries in these topics to understand, please let me know in the comment section. I will try to put notes for you in the description box only, so that it becomes more convenient to you to write the notes, okay? Thanks for watching.